From Lagos, the nation's commercial capital, this is the News at 10. Live from Channels Television, reporting tonight, Amarachi Ubani.
Good evening and welcome. Tonight, APC leadership crisis takes a new twist as court grants interim injunction suspending the party's national chairman, Mr. Adams Oshiomhole. APC promises to abide by a court decision on the suspension of its national chairman as police take over party secretariats in the nation's capital in a move to avert a breakdown of law and order. The federal government considers a review of the 2020 budget assumptions following falling prices of crude oil in the international market due to coronavirus outbreak. And it leads to shut all schools from Thursday for 10 days as it steps up efforts to contain the COVID-19 outbreak as death toll rises. Plus, business, sports, news from Abuja, the FCT, and later, international news from our London studios.
On business news tonight, World Health Organization warns that banknotes may be spreading the coronavirus, asks customers to use contactless payments.
On sports news tonight, Germany-based Kingsley Ihezuo and Holland-based Cyril Dessers get their maiden call-ups to the Super Eagles for this month's 2021 Africa Cup of Nations qualifiers against Sierra Leone.
Hello, and from Abuja, President of the Senate Ahmed Lawan expresses dissatisfaction with the state of the isolation center for coronavirus at the University of Abuja Teaching Hospital.
Mr. Adams Oshiomhole will no longer sit as the national chairman of the All Progressives Congress, at least for now. That's because an Abuja High Court, presided over by Justice Dunlemi Senchi, granted an order of interlocutory injunction seeking his suspension pending the hearing and a termination of the main suit. The application was filed by the national vice chairman of the party in the northeast, Mustafa Saliu, and five others. A court held that the party wrongfully continues to retain Mr. Oshiomhole as its national chairman while he is still under suspension by his ward in Esako West, Ward 10 in Edo State. Justice Senchi further ordered Comrade Oshiomhole to stop parading himself as the national chairman of the party and directed the party to stop acknowledging him in that regard. Although the lawyer to the suspended national chairman, Mr. Damian Dodo, declined comments, lawyer to the plaintiff speaks on the reason behind the action.
What it means is that from this very moment, the first defendant, Mr. Adams Oshiomhole, ceases to be the chairman of APC. That's what it means. At least it's an interlocutory injunction. What it means is that until the substantive suit is decided, he can no longer act as a chairman of APC from this very moment, as the court has ruled. We came for the order because we believe in the rule of law. That's simply the reason why we're here, to make sure that the Constitution is respected. Our contention is very simple, that Mr. Oshiomhole was suspended by his ward. And if you are a suspended member, you cannot reap the benefits of full membership. So all we're saying is that his right as a member of APC is in abatement at the very minimum at this point in time. That's what we're saying. So we just wanted the law, we just wanted the court to give voice to what members of his local ward have said.
Mr. Oshiomhole's party, the All Progressives Congress, is ready to respect the decision of the Abuja High Court, which granted the interlocutory injunction. APC National Secretary, Mr. Victor Gyadom, explains that the party is law-abiding and that its National Working Committee will meet soon to deliberate on the challenges it is currently facing.
That we'll find, as a law-abiding party, we will respect all lawful court order and progress from that point. And very soon, the National Working Committee will meet and you will hear further from the party. But just to say that all the All Progressive Congress will respect all lawful order of courts. We will also do that.
On the contrary, Mr. Oshomole's chief press secretary, Simon Ebebulem, says his legal team is currently reviewing the matter and have filed an appeal. He mentioned this in a statement sent to our correspondent, saying, "We have filed for a stay of execution and appealed the ruling." With those processes currently before the appeal court, Comrade Anams Oshomole remains the national chairman of the party. But Channel Television is yet to receive a copy of the court's document showing that indeed an application has been filed for a stay of execution. Meanwhile, policemen have taken over security at the National Secretariat of the party in Abuja to forestall a breakdown of law and order. The story is, however, different in the home state of the APC in Edo State, where the state chapter of the party has been commending the court injunction. The state chairman of the party, Anselmo Jezua, the Edo State governor, Godwin Obaseki, and his deputy, Philip Shaibu, gathered at a press conference in Benin City, where they agreed that the order of the court will fast-track the peace process to end crisis in the state.
This is not a time to rejoice. For us, it is a very sad commentary. Not only because we helped to put that man in office, but because we also have a responsibility to ensure that whatever he does rubs off on the rest of us. But what is even more, the likelihood that a man could abuse his office was so manifest that we feared that the very tenets and the foundations of democracy were being threatened. I believe with what has happened, the court has provided our party a proper atmosphere and a conducive environment for the reconciliation that we seek, so that we can achieve the peace that we need to provide and deliver on the promises we made to our people and to appropriately prepare for the elections that is imminent this year.
Let's examine this issue further. We've been joined on the News at 10 by legal practitioner, Mr. GT Ogunye. Thank you for joining us on the News at 10.
Thanks for inviting me.
We seem to be going in and out of courts these days. I mean, for the past 2 weeks, this has been the story. What is your reaction, though, to today's decision of the court suspending Mr. Oshomole as a national chairman of the APC?
Well, my general view is that APC is facing a political crisis. It's an internal party imbroglio and power tussle because it's the ruling party. And so it's an important party in the country. And so when you have this kind of crisis within the party, inevitably, because this is Nigeria, partisans will have recourse to the court to bolster their position and to wear out their adversaries. So this is the typical internal party crisis that then dovetailed into a legal battle in the court. Now, when the news broke, I was just wondering, because as a lawyer, I was concerned about the seeming ineluctable presence of our courts in political matters, almost in a perpetual manner. And I was dismayed by that. I recognize that under the Constitution, and I'm referencing Section 66B of the Constitution, once parties have their disputes, they have a right to access the court.
Yeah, but do you think they needed to take it this far?
But the court also has a responsibility to look at things critically and then say, look, don't bother us too much here. My understanding of where the matter stands out today is that following that order of injunction, there has been an appeal and that there's also has been an application for stay of execution of that interlocutory decision. Once you have this, they operate as a stay, and then the person against whom an injunction, another injunction has been granted, can then claim to continue to do whatever he wants to do, pending the determination of that application for stay of execution, one way or the other.
So, pending the stay of execution, who is chairman of the party?
That's what the law says. If you are injuncted, and following that order of injunction, you file an application you file a notice of appeal under Section 241 of the Constitution, and then you file an application for stay, pending the hearing and determination of that application for stay, one way or the other, it's like you've stayed it, pending when that application is determined. And the person against whom that order has been made can then claim that it will continue to act one way or the other.
Is this a matter you think that the party could have dealt with internally rather than taking it to the courts and, you know, displaying all of these judiciary prowess in front of Nigerians?
Let's be historical here. Right from the time of the First Republic, the AG wanted to remove a deputy, a premier, and then eventually they landed in court. And the matter went all the way to the Privy Council in England. Mm-hmm. So I'm submitting that here, political crises take the coloration of legal battles because partisans want to bolster their position, strengthen themselves, fight it out, and then gain supremacy over themselves in the course of the political party they are engaging in. It would have been better for the party that is a ruling party, having a president, to be able to resolve his own internal affairs without. And what many people are seeing is that perhaps those who hold political offices in the party and who therefore hold influence within the party are a little bit laid back. Or perhaps they are the ones stoking the crisis. Otherwise, they should have been able to, you know, stem this and allow and not allow this to get to this point.
And then what happens now? What direction does this go?
Well, the matter will be fought in the courts. If there is an interlocutory appeal and an application for stay of execution, one can envision that there can even be an application for stay of proceedings of that court, because the party may say, oh, you've granted an injunction against me, so I'm not going to have fair hearing before you. Mm-hmm. And then the matter will shift to the Court of Appeal, and from there, eventually, it will then go to the... So what we're going to see is that even though we've not gotten to 2023 yet, our courts that are just getting out of the election petition determination cycle and the review of appeal cycle will be busy, because politicians want our court to be busy. Just because here, as I said earlier, it's all about positioning and fighting for privileges and opportunities that politics bring in our country.
And I'm just wondering how this reflects on, you know, the governance of Nigeria itself. For a ruling party to have internal fighting, what does that say?
Well, what it says about us is that, yes, they may say that, politicians may say that they are governing, but there are very important things to the lives of the people of Nigeria. When you wake up and you hear that 51 people have been slaughtered in one place, 30-something slaughtered in another place, in quick succession, you get worried. And so when those issues are not being tackled, you know, very well, and you're hearing about politicians fighting themselves and all that, you just look at it that, well, maybe they are so disconnected from the ordinary people. What bothers the ordinary people doesn't bother them. And perhaps this is the only thing that concerns them. Power for power's sake, and power, unfortunately, in many instances, for primitive accumulation of capital.
Mr. Jiti Oguyem, a pleasure having you on the News at 10 tonight. Thanks again.
It's my pleasure.
In part two after the break, concerns continue to mount over impact of coronavirus. The federal government plans review of 2020 budget assumptions as awareness campaign increases. Please join us again.